Hello students, we are going to recover CLSP online lecture, and today we will discuss about what is prospectus. In last videos we have seen what is the meaning of memorandum and articles of association. These are the primary and the secondary document from the company's point of view, means in the initial stage when the company is in the process of incorporation, these documents are essential to draft from each proposed company's point of view. So today we will see what is prospectus. Now, as you know that memorandum and articles are the documents, likewise prospectus is also a document. And in general also, means in routine life also, you must have heard about prospectus. Largely you have observed that when you are in your admission process, okay, while taking the admission you are filling the form in any college, okay, and when you fill the form or when you purchase a form from the college, along with the form you receive prospectus. So what is prospectus? It is the detailed information about that particular college, when the college has been started, what is the establishing year of the college, okay, how successfully the college is running, what are the achievements of its college, rather what are the successive points, okay, means how many students who have received merit in university or in the colleges where they belong to. So each and every detailed information is included in that prospectus. So prospectus is what? Prospectus is a document. So from Companies Act or from our CLSP point of view, what prospectus says? Prospectus means a document. So when a public company is collecting the capital by issuing shares to the public, then it has to issue a document which is called prospectus. So prospectus is a document which contains information about the various aspects about the company and invites the investors to buy the security offered by the company. It means they are providing or they are giving the offer, they are giving each and every detail, how equity shares, preference shares, how much the dividend they will earn, each and every information regarding that public company to increase the capital by issuing shares. Okay, so they are including all the information in that particular booklet or a handbook which is known as prospectus. So what is the definition of prospectus? Section 2 under section 70 of Companies Act 2013, prospectus means any document described or issued as a prospectus and includes articles 32A, red herring prospectus or shelf prospectus, or any notice, circular, advertisement or other document inviting offers from the public for the subscription or the purchase of any security of a body corporate. Body corporate means of a company, proposed company, or a company which is already in existence. So red herring document, okay, shelf prospectus, notice, okay, all these are the different types of prospectus which we are going to see further. So what is prospectus? It is a document which contains information regarding company, and it also offers or invites the investors to purchase or to buy the securities offered by the company. Now what are the different types of prospectus? Abridged prospectus, shelf prospectus, red herring prospectus, letter of offer and offer letter. These are the two different types, letter of offer and offer letter. Now what are these? The first one is abridged prospectus. What it contains? It contains the main contents, means the index only we can call. Suppose any textbook, how it is, earlier the index is given, and in the index you will just find the name of the particular chapters, okay, the name of the lessons, and again inside that, means in the coming pages, in the next pages, all the information regarding each and every lesson is given. So what is abridged prospectus? It contains, it includes the main contents of a prospectus, but in brief, in short, they are mentioning regarding the contents of the company. It is attached with the application form issued by a company while offering its securities. Okay, when it is issued, it is attached with the application form issued by the company while offering its security. Abridged prospectus is issued only in case of public offer made by a company. So when abridged prospectus is issued, only in case of public offer made by the company. Then shelf prospectus. A public company may raise funds by the company from the public by issuing securities as and when it needs more funds. For every such issue, fresh prospectus is to be issued. So shelf prospectus is a fresh prospectus, whereas abridged means it is issued along with the application form, okay, while offering its security. But it is a fresh prospectus. Which one? Shelf prospectus. The process of preparing and registering a prospectus is very time consuming. Thus, instead of preparing fresh prospectus, every issue a company can prepare shelf prospectus. Shelf means it is a kind of cover, okay? Shelf. So shelf prospectus can be used all issues made by the company up to 1 year from the date of first offering of securities under the prospectus. However, an information memorandum is to be filled with the ROC, means register of company, every time a subsequent offer of security is made during the validity period of 1 year of the shelf prospectus. The information memorandum contains latest material facts such as any new charges created on assets of the company, changes in the financial position from the date of its succeeding offers. So you just need to see what is shelf prospectus. Okay, fresh prospectus is to be issued. The process of preparing and registering fresh prospectus is a very time consuming. Thus, instead of preparing fresh prospectus for every issue, a company can prepare a shelf prospectus. Okay, it is used for all the issues made by the company. Means every time, whenever they are giving a public offer regarding their shares, okay, they are issuing shelf prospectus. Then red herring. Red herring is a kind of incomplete prospectus as it does not include complete particulars of the quantity of securities offered or the issue price of the securities being offered. It is usually issued at the time of IPO. Okay, so or any issue. So what is this IPO? IPO is initial public offer. So it is usually issued at the time of initial public offer or any issue done under the book building process. Okay, so what is IPO? Initial public offer is when company offers its shares for the first time to the public. Book building process means it is a process by which company determines issue price of securities based on the demand from the public. Okay, a red herring prospectus shall have the same obligations that are applicable to the prospectus. A company must file a red herring prospectus with ROC at least 3 days prior to the opening of the subscription list and the offer. Okay, the next type is letter of offer. When a company undertakes further issue of shares by making a right issue, that is offering shares directly to its existing shareholders in proportion to the shares held by them, the company issue a document called letter of offer. It contains the detail of the offer. What is this detail? Letter of offer. When a company undertakes further issue of shares by making a right issue, that is offering shares directly to its existing shareholders. Okay, see, this is somehow used or this is somehow issued for the existing shareholders, means the persons who have already purchased, the shareholders who have already purchased the shares of the company. So it is for them, for the existing shareholders in proportion to the shares held by them. A company issue a document called letter of offer. It contains the details of the offer, means what kind of offer they are giving, at which price, what will be the price of equity share, what will the price of preference shares. Okay, they are containing the detail regarding the offer. Offer letter. Now again, this is different. Letter of offer and offer letter. An offer letter is issued to select a group of investors by a company when it makes private placement offer or security. Private placement means a company is offering its shares to any selected group of investors. Again, existing shareholders and the special investors or the special shareholders also. So offer letter is for special investors or the persons who are really interested in buying the shares of that specific company. Then company select such group and they are giving offer for the buying of the shares only to those special investors, okay, and they are giving, and it is known as private placement. So what it means, when a company is offering its shares to any selected group of investors, correct? So this is offer letter. Now, contents of prospectus. What is included? What are the different contents of prospectus? Information and reports. As per the Companies Act, prospectus must contain information such as the name of the issuing company, its full registered office, address with phone numbers, email, nature, number and price of securities being offered, details of lead merchant bankers registered to the issue, names of the stock exchange, which shares are to be listed, whether NSE or BSE, okay, National Stock Exchange or Bombay Stock Exchange, a clause on general risk, date of opening and closing of issue, etc. It must also have reports on financial information. SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India, specifies the contents to be included in the prospectus. Kya kya hona chahiye prospectus mein? Okay, company ka registered office with phone number, email address, nature of the company, then number and price of securities being offered. This is main thing. Number and price of securities offered. Detail of lead merchant banker, who are the bankers of that particular company, register of to the issues, name of stock exchange, BSE or NSE, okay. So this is the information and report, and this is the first content of prospectus. Second, declaration. There should be a declaration by the company saying that all the provisions of the Companies Act have been compiled with and that the prospectus does not contain anything contrary to the provision of the Companies Act, Securities Contract Regulation Act and SEBI Act 1992 and rules and regulations made under them. It means they are declaring. It is compulsory for them. For them means for whom? The company. It is compulsory for the company to declare and provide the correct information regarding the company. And as per the Companies Act 2013, at the same time, Securities and Contract Act 1956 and SEBI Act 1992. Which rules they need to follow? Securities Contract Act 1956 and SEBI Act 1992 and the rules and regulations made under them. These two acts. In declaration, the company has to follow which contract act, that is Securities Contract Act and SEBI Act 1992. They have to declare as per the provisions made under Contract Act and SEBI Act. Okay. Then statement of an expert. A prospectus may contain a statement made by an expert like a company secretary, chartered accountant, cost accountant, valuer, engineer relating to the matter that they have looked in. The expert has to give written consent of the issue of the prospectus. Okay. So statement of an expert means every company used to appoint CA, CAs, tax consultants. Okay. So a prospectus may contain a statement. So in every prospectus there must be a statement which has been declared or which has been announced by the expert like CS, CA, okay, or cost accountant, valuer, engineer relating to the matters they have looked in. For example, CA, he has prepared the balance sheet. It means in the prospectus he must mention or he must give his statement related regarding the balance sheet, how factual the balance sheet is and whatever it may be the content. Okay, so they must give their expert opinion or statement of an expert. Any other matter as may be prescribed by the Companies Act. Okay, but these three contents are important, and if there is any other matter which is mentioned in Companies Act, then the company can also include those in the contents of the prospectus. Clear? So what is the golden rule? okay, there is one statement which is known as golden rule for framing the prospectus. And this golden rule was laid down, or this golden rule was given by Justice Kendersley in New Brunswick and Canada Railway and Land Company. What is the rule is? Okay, what the rule says? What is, and that rule is known as golden rule for framing the prospectus. And that rule is, those who issue a prospectus hold out to the public great significance, the persons who will take shares in the proposed undertakings. Public is invited to subscribe shares on the faith of the representation contained in the prospectus. The public is at the mercy of company promoters. Everything must, therefore, be stated with the strict accuracy. They must not omit any material fact within their knowledge which may adversely affect the nature, extent, or a quality of the privileges and advantages which the prospectus assures to the subscribers. In a word, a true nature of the company's venture should be disclosed. So, what this golden rule says? Whatever the information is included in the prospectus, okay, the promoters, okay, and or and if the company is running old, it means it is already in existence, then in that case, the directors or the managing directors or other responsible persons, what they should do? They must contain each and every material fact in the prospectus. They should not omit any material fact. At the same time, it includes the factual information regarding the company, because finally, the shareholders, who are the shareholders? They are buying the shares, and after buying the shares, company's capital is increased. It means company is earning money after selling the shares. So every prospectus must contain the true and very factual information regarding the company in whatever the business activity they are dealing with. They should give each and every fact. They must contain all the real and correct information regarding the company in their prospectus. This is what is the golden rule. Now, statutory requirement in relation to the prospectus. Draft prospectus to be made public. A draft prospectus filed with SEBI by the company should be made available to the public and to the stock exchanges where the company wants to list shares. Then, signed by directors. Prospectus must be signed by all the directors or by the duly authorized attorney. Means, who are the authorized person for signing the prospectus. Registration of prospectus. A copy of the prospectus must be registered with the ROC before issuing to the public. Again, this is the rule. Okay, this is the statutory requirements. Means every company must follow these requirements before issuing the prospectus to the public. Okay, what is that? Draft prospectus to be made to the public. Then it must be signed by the authorized directors. Then before issuing to the public, that copy of the prospectus must be registered with the ROC, Register of Company Office. Then dating of prospectus has to be dated. The date on the prospectus is considered at the date of publication of the prospectus. Okay, then issuing prospectus to the public. Finally, the prospectus is ready for the issue. So prospectus must be issued to the public within 90 days from the date of registering a copy with the ROC. Once that copy is registered with the ROC, then from that date, within 90 days, that prospectus must be issued to the public. So these are the general rules and regulations regarding issue of prospectus. Now, penalty for non-compliance. What is the penalty? Like, if the prospectus is issued in contravention of the above mentioned provisions, the penalty is followed. Means, if the company is not following these statutory requirements relating to the prospectus, then what will happen? Penalty. The company has to pay the penalty for not obeying the statutory requirements regarding the prospectus. So, if the prospectus is issued in contravention of the above mentioned provisions, the penalty is as follows. What is that penalty? A company shall be liable to pay a fine between 50,000 and 3 lakhs, and every person who has knowing involved in issuing such prospectus will be 3 lakhs or with both. Means 50,000 and 3 lakhs. Means there is a penalty. Means they are liable to pay the fees, okay, for not including the factual information or not following the provisions which are made statutory for issue of prospectus. And see, that non-compliance for a penalty is different thing. Again, what is next? Misstatement. Okay, if you have given something wrong in the prospectus, and if the company has not followed the statutory requirement, then there is a penalty. Again, penalty is again a different issue. And if you are including any misstatement, okay, for example, your company has been established in the year 1984, and in the prospectus you are mentioning it that it is established in 1964, so 20 years gap means you are giving all the information which is not true. Okay, if the establishing year itself is wrong, then again it is a kind of crime, so they are liable for the penalty, or they are liable for some other civil liability and criminal liability in case of misstatement in the prospectus, as the investors make their decisions to invest based on the information given in the prospectus. Obviously, the investors, the shareholders, when they will buy the shares, after going through with the prospectus, they are buying the shares. But if the information which is included in the prospectus is not correct, that is called misstatement in the prospectus, then the investors make their decision to invest based on the information given in the prospectus. Care should be taken to ensure all the information is accurate and no material fact is omitted. An untrue statement or misstatement means the statement is misleading in the form or in content. It means whatever the achievements you have written in the prospectus, and those achievements are wrong. You have actually not achieved anything regarding the profit, anything regarding the awards or the different kinds of achievements, and still you are mentioning those in your prospectus. That is known as misstatement. The misleading in the form or content, or where any inclusion of a statement or its omission is likely to mislead the reader. If an investor has bought shares of a shares based on the company prospectus which had misleading information or suppressed material information, then he can take action against the company. Means the shareholder, the investor has a right to take action on the company. If there is any untrue or misstatement in the prospectus, the company and persons responsible for issuing such prospectus will have to face following liability. Means which liability? One is civil liability, another is criminal liability. What comes under civil liability? Pay compensation for loss suffered by the investors. Okay, means company has to pay the compensation. Okay, for example, the person who have purchased 1000 rupees shares of the company, so they have to pay the penalty, or they have to pay the compensation for the loss. That 1000 is the loss of the investor, then it comes under civil liability. So pay compensation for the loss suffered by the investor. And another is criminal liability. Company or its officers will be fined or imprisoned or both. Fined, imprisoned means they have to face, they need to go for the jail. Okay, imprisonment maybe for some period, or maybe duration of 1 day, 2 day, as per the company's act mentioned in the company act. So that comes under criminal liability. So misstatement, if they are putting any misstatement regarding the company, then the persons who are responsible for issuing the prospectus, they have to face the liability, either civil liability or criminal liability. It means you have made a crime, okay, because you have given some untrue information, some misstatement in the prospectus, then you are liable for civil liability as well as criminal liability. Correct? So this is all regarding the prospectus. Okay, so we will stop here, and our specifically this lecture contains all the details regarding prospectus.